Good evening, respected ones. This video brings before you a theory called Difference Theory of Language. This theory is mainly propagated by a sociolinguist called Deborah Tannen. According to this theory, there is a huge difference in the usage of language by male and female members of the society on the basis of their physical and psychological nature. According to Deborah Tannen, this difference is clearly seen when the members of these two sexual counterparts communicate with each other. As she has recognized through a study, different types of differences or different categories of differences. Let's look at these features of male and female language uses. The first pattern is status versus support. According to Deborah Tannen, male community always wants for getting a better status in the society, but female community always wants to get support from others. When male counterparts use language, they always use some words which denotes their status, while female counterparts use the words which denote support. For example, if, according to Tannen, if a husband and wife travel together, the husband will be telling a person who is standing at the entrance of the train, just like this: please give us way. Why do you stand here? You also have to travel by this train. But the wife will be telling just like this: sir, would you please help us to enter the train, as we also have to travel by this train. Tannen quotes her own experience when traveling with her husband. So the first pattern, the pattern of difference is status versus support. The second pattern is of difference is advice versus understanding. Advice versus understanding. According to Tannen, men community or men always want to solve the problems, while women community always want to get some sympathy out of their problems. And this nature can be seen in the linguistic usages also, according to Tannen. For example, if we can take the traveling again, if there is a problem in between the travel, like the husband and wife faces some shortage of water to drink, the husband will ask the co-passenger, "Sir, would you please tell me, can I get a bottle of water in the next station?" While the wife's request will be just like this: "Sir, would you please give us a bottle of water if you don't mind?" So they always see the sympathy, they always seek the sympathy, according to Tannen. Then the third pattern of difference is information versus feelings. According to Tannen, men community always use language for getting information, while women community always use language for fulfilling their feelings. They would use language for creating relationships, keeping relationships, and not to break relationships. So men community will be using some shouting words, while women community will use only some words by which they can create relationships rather than breaking relationships. Then another pattern of difference in the case of male language and woman language is conflict versus compromise. Here, women community always try to solve problems, or women community always show disagree, always solve the conflict between two people, while men community would always try to solve the problem through some conflict with others. They never make use of a language of compromise, but women community always would use language of compromise, according to Tannen. So men always tell the words such as, "I strongly disagree with you. I have got an objection against your point. I cannot agree with your point at any sense, so and so. But women community would use, yes, I agree with your point, but I think let's have a modification in that. So this is the difference in the usage of language, that is conflict versus compromise. Then the fifth pattern of difference according to Tannen is orders versus proposals. Men always give orders, like open the door, close the door. But women community always present some proposals, like, can we open the door? Please open the door if you don't mind. I think opening the door is good for us, etc. So this is what is difference theory. According to Deborah Tannen, men and women are selecting words, sentences, and phrases, that is, are selecting language in different manner on the basis of their sexual nature in the society, on the basis of their role in the society. And all these views are views of Deborah Tannen, not mine, right?